The Rays complete the sweep in the Bronx in this afternoon with a 10-5 win. Just a forgettable 3 days for a variety of reasons for the Yankees.
Yeah, deflating day today that ends a deflating series, punctuated by ineffective pitching, some sloppy play. The Yankees are now knocked out of first place because the Rays took these three games. The Yankees have been in sole possession of first place for 22 straight days. And, Bob, there's so much to dissect from this game. James Paxton looked terrific for the first four innings, and then he labored in that fifth inning. He had talked about making some adjustments, some mechanical adjustments to pick up his velo. Remember, he had that back surgery, and he just soured in that inning. And then the Yankee bullpen after that, Ottavino and Avalon struggled. We didn't see Chad Green, which is curious. And then on top of all that, the Yankees lose another player, Gleyber Torres, to a hamstring injury. So a frustrating day all around.
Yeah, we'll hear from Aaron Boone about Gleyber and his status and more. Buck Showalter joins us now. Buck, I had your voice in my head during the game. How you said day game after a night game, you know, Yankees would feed off the energy of a crowd. It seems like these last 3 days, the Rays were very comfortable with the atmosphere in the Bronx.
Yeah, you could tell that. And they knew that they were going to have to use multiple pitchers today. And they're using, you know, guys are, regardless of their background, their experience. I mean, Slugger's got called up today, and he's pitching a three-run lead in the eighth inning. That's who they are. But you can tell they got their ears pinned back. They're letting it fly. They feel like they're playing with house money. And, you know, the Yankees looked a little flat today. But I thought Paxton was great for four innings. He used all of his pitches, even though his velocity was still down somewhat. I thought the changeup and the breaking ball and the command of all three pitchers about as good as I've seen it. And like you said, Jack, the fifth inning just didn't happen for him.
The bottom line is the Rays win this one 10-5. So they have now won 6 of 7 against the Yankees this season. They won 3 of 4 in St. Pete. And you take a look at the season by opponents. Against everybody else, the Yankees have just torn it up. 15-3, averaging more than 6 runs a game. But just 1-6 against the Rays, 3.4 runs. The average down, the home runs per game down, Buck. To your point, it's a great reminder, if nothing else, and the shortened season gives a little more concern, is that the Rays up and down have a very good pitching staff and very good continuity and just solid people at positions.
Yeah, and they've got such depth. You see the people they're bringing into games. It's just, you talk about next man up, that's the way they look at their bullpen. Well, it's your turn to pitch. You're physically able to go. What inning is it? I don't care. You know, you just came up from minor leagues. I don't care. You know, we talk about, you know, we want to be cautious. This season, sometimes caution has to be thrown in the wind a little bit, and you're going to have to do some things unconventionally. And I think that's what everybody's struggling to grasp, is what is your level of sense of urgency in a 60-game season. And these games certainly reveal that.
Buck, I think you said something at the beginning of this series that was so vital, and it proved to be true. The Rays don't fear the Yankees. They're more a familiar foe, not a feared foe. They see them so often, they go head-to-head. It's sort of the idea of know your enemy. And I think the Rays know the Yankees very well. Yes, the Yankees know the Rays very well. But when you look at this series, the Rays simply outplayed the Yankees.
Well, it's also, you know, we talked also, Jack, about presentation. And we were also talking about presence. And these are good players. And they can win with what they have now. The presentation and the just the status that some of the guys that are out present over the course of these series, it's the stuff they're missing as much as the statistics.